Hey guys, how you doing? So now that I'm back, I've realized I've made a mistake and I've accidentally saved over the scarf with the fix applied. So I'm gonna check if my older scene has. I don't think it will, but we can check. Oh, it does. Good. So I don't know if it's is the latest model or not. But basically, I need to export this Z tool. So yeah, let's save as. I'm just gonna. Let's see. Transfix modeling. ZBrush. Sculpting. Exports. ZTL. To rename the other files as well. Okay, so let's append. I'm going to import loader tool even. Let's go into this guy. Load tool. Okay. Delete. For a while, I think. Okay. And delete you, and delete you. So now I can append headscarf geo. So this one is the one with the fixed thickness. Okay. Let's delete that. But I need to compare them, don't I? Can't undo. Never mind. Oh well. I love your work from Algeria. Thanks, man. I appreciate it. There we go. So let's go. I need to start grouping and naming these, don't I? Let's quickly rename that. Please, more tutorials for Yeti. I don't actually use Yeti anymore. I haven't even installed it on this machine, and I got this computer back in like June. So let's go to geometry, dynamic subdiv. Let's do 0.065. That feels about right. Let's add 2 segments. Okay, so draw. Right, so we got everything back. That's good. So what was the next thing I wanted to do? Need to get the UVs into the other scene. So let's check the UVs of this guy. That's fine. UV shell. Layout. I'll throw all the clothing into the same thing. So let's go File, Export Selection, Modeling, Maya, Exports, hit Scoff Geo. Okay. Didn't mean to do that, but okay. Okay, so import Maya exports. There we go, that's better. Cool. So let's see. We need to obviously work on the knot, get the knot actually in there. And I need to, while I remember, clean up the ZBrush folder. There we go. Body underscore geo. Spell it right this time. And new folder. Disp. Cool. And go into the multimap exporter. So you plug in multimap. File names. Displacement map. It's gonna put underscore Z disp. Z plugin. Create all maps. I saw a message. I'm just gonna do this and then I'll read the message. Okay. Please, what is the best using XYZ color or hand painting skin? I think you're oversimplifying it, like best at what? Like doing realistic stuff? Because if so, texture transfer Z. Hand paint is never going to beat that, really. It'll take a long time if you did. But if you need to do stylized character, then XYZ would be a pretty bad option. But I'd say if you're new to modeling, or new to CG even, try to detach yourself from the word best. It really means nothing. Okay, so color fill object. Right. Let's start getting these things in the right place. Okay, gotta focus shift up. Hide the body here. around a lot more. Obviously, this is like extremely basic. I haven't convinced this is how a knot is tied, but we'll get there. Looks vaguely like a knot from a distance. Need to pull that in now. Pull that way. What I'll need to do is pinch this in. But now I have to figure out where does everything else go? Like, I'm not actually sure. I could just, like, tie a knot in front of me, but that'd be too easy, wouldn't it? From the front, that looks like a knot, kind of. It just looks a bit stranger. So that goes okay, so we know that's tracking. Okay. So you need to end here somehow. need a piece of string. Or just a wire. A bit tough. I'll get a t-shirt, 1 second. Have some Christmas pajamas. I'll tie these into a knot. You guys can't see, I don't think, mostly what I'm doing, but I'm wondering how tightly would you tie this? Wheels falling off my chair as well. What is going on right now? There we go. So, like, how loosely would you tie this? I guess that would do, wouldn't it? In which case, this is tying to the wrong side. Kind of. This side. I'm still not entirely sure what we need. I don't know why that threw me through more of a loop. To sort out the ears as well, don't I? The ears just get flattened in, I guess so. Okay, I'm gonna quickly create some folders, I think. Body. kind of works, right? There'd be a seam in the texture. So I need to make it one piece. It's also intersecting the throat, which is a bit of a problem. Mike, how was the break? As in the lunchtime? It's nice. Just a walk and a big heap of salmon. What did you eat? Had some honey roast salmon with some rice and spinach and eggs. And then a bowl of granola. Then a protein bar. I'm currently on a bulk because I'm eating a lot of calories. Any problems with Wi-Fi? No, nothing today. It's starting to look kind of okay. Will you groom an extra this time? Yes. At least I intend to. Okay, so let's rotate. I feel like I need to do that as a blend shape or something. And that kind of works in its own way, but... Okay. So how do I want to go about doing the headscarf then? How do I want to now go through and make this do the shapes? Or do I just keep that separate, that model separate? Merge it later, maybe. Because that does undoubtedly work. Like visually, at least. If I merge down with this guy. To geometry, delete lower, merge down. Export. This will count as block out, so ZBrush block out exports. Block out, scarf, tie, geo. Okay. Reference editor, where you went? I can just hide these for now, I guess. File, import. How close is everything? Fucking miles away, mate. Like, not even remotely close. ZBrush block out exports. Yeah, I need to get it updated, don't I? Export. Scarf is getting really close already. Still got a while to go yet, but yeah, it's definitely picking up. Exports. Okay. So a file, import. Okay, so deform, blend shape. Okay, delete history, go to you. Then file, import. Display properties, no. Polygroups, multigroup. Sculpting, exports. I'll read your comment in a moment, Vivian. Just gonna get this done. Headscarf. Fix a D1, yep, that's fine. Okay, and back into Maya. I just want to do this before I lose the train of thought. There we go. Right. How do you get the eyes to look nice and ZBrush like that? Is it just a polypaint and polypaint and a shiny shader? Yes. It's literally all it is. I did it in, I believe, the first stream. And so if you want to see it, then it's going there. But it's literally just toy plastic. The material toy plastic, I mean. And a texture painted like this. I've been doing it like this for years now. It works well. One of the key elements though is that you, if we can find this, sculpt a basic cornea like that and just stretches the reflections when you expect it to, like that. Get stuff like that. And save your iThreads. Okay, let's increase the diffuse. There's zero diffuse right now, okay. 0.6. Nah, that's close enough. Yeah, it makes it look way better than if you put. Yeah, it makes a huge difference. Strongly recommend painting some basic iris. Okay, it's locking up a bit. I need to sharpen up that line though. But that seems to be working well. So I feel like we should start doing proper lineups, like real ones now. What's your experience, opinion so far concerning Rombotools shaders? They seem alright. I mean, I've not really got deep into them, I've literally just assigned them. So I really can't say for sure. I'd say it'd be better to ask that question once I've actually started shading. Redepth 3 should be fine. System. Trying to remember where you find some of these settings. Actually. So let's export the hair. So it'll be in block out exports, block out hair. Okay. I'll be back then, thanks a lot. Cool, no worries. Beautiful. I'm wondering how I want to approach these. Like, do I do a separate tooth shader and gum shader and blend? Or do I do one material that does both and just do a shit ton of masking? Just not sure on that one. Bring that back in. Oh, I need to import that, don't I? Import. So bright by default. Okay, then deform, blend shape. The eyes looking inwards. Let's do a slight. Let's do 2.5 and negative 2.5 on this one. Oh. That would explain it. What did you do? Oh, what did I do? I don't know. I don't know what you're asking. There we go. The concept is really classy. Yeah, it's really, really nice. Definitely check out the work of the artist, you can find it in the description. That feels better. Okay, so what do I need to do? Close enough. Now is where we start doing likeness changes, I guess. I'm wondering, do we get a pass of textures? Like, not now, but like, do we do textures before all the other stuff? It would have been nice if I actually looked at the knot first, right? Remodel that. I need to add a bit more neck, I think. Both here and here. Like neck width. She does have her head turned. Hey, old leaf. Oh, she has to be born in the, from the 1890s at least. Maybe, I'm not sure. Z intensity, 2. That was a bit far forward. That feels really weird. Although I guess her arms should be aimed more down, right? I guess we could do that now, actually. To learn to use this tool. How do you make smooth meshes this clean without the lumpiness? I think I've told you a few times. I just use a really soft brush. I use clay buildup, no alpha, Z intensity of 2. Do not sculpt with that brush all the time. I would be mad if you do. It's just a really good brush for changing forms without really having the opportunity to make lumpy stuff. Like, in a way, it kind of can't. It's just too soft. Keep that in mind. My renders have been giving me crazy wake-up call recently. Yeah, I mean, I think I've told you a few times in Discord, like, just render in Maya. Like, ZBrush viewport really doesn't take you that far. Like, you can get very far with it, but it doesn't really tell you what's wrong, so it kind of requires experience to know what's wrong. Get the low res back into Maya. Loving checking up on this progress. Thanks, man. Sorry, it's completely blanked for a moment there. Do you use V-Ray at all? I used it professionally for the last year and a half. What's up? Modeling, ZBrush, sculpting, exports. File, import. Deform, blend shape. That's better. So the eyes are the next thing. The eyes are completely wrong right now. Ugh, don't want to do the eyes. Like, eye line up so where it starts to get really tricky. Have any water left? I don't. Right, I'm just going to fill up my water. One sec. Lovely. I use it at work too. Do you know any learning resources which are near standards of Ovid's tutorials? I'm mainly using most of my Arnold Furry and LitDev, and I'm curious. I mean, Grant Warwick, but his stuff is increasingly getting outdated. Just because, like, his knowledge is incredible, and his tutorials are amazing. But they're for V-Ray 3.2, I think. 3.1, maybe? Because now I was using, like, 2.4 when I first found them. And now it's, what, V-Ray 6, V-Ray 7? I'm not even sure. Vahad, very cool. Thanks, man. So what I'm missing out on techniques-wise? LookDev is the same between any tools, really. Like, V-Ray has some differences, but they're all still LookDev. The main differences come in when you start doing... Oh, I need to move that hair over. The main differences come in when you start doing stuff with refraction. Yeah, Grant Warwick is amazing. Really one of the best resources there is. It's a shame he kind of stopped making stuff. In fact, I think he scrubbed his social media of CG at one point. So he obviously doesn't want to be bothered by it anymore, which is fair. Okay, I'm going to sculpt the hair a little bit. I say a little bit, I mean a little bit. It's literally just to move this bit forward. Like, that's enough. Export, block out, exports, hair. He's made a new game. Oh, that's cool. Will you give her hands? I have no reason to give her hands. I'm not going down that rabbit hole. Getting close. I need to turn the body at some point. But you can see how this shoulder is too low and this one's too high. And that's not an issue with the model, I don't think. I think that's this. Like, just turning the shoulder. That will visibly raise one and lower the other. Plus a little bit of relaxation in one shoulder. One's a little bit more tense. That combination will kind of do what we need. Friend might not be able to make it to lunch tomorrow. Okay. I swear this used to line up better. Apparently it doesn't line up at all anymore. It's getting closer. Give it that. If that bit lines up now. Close enough. So let's fix the rest to it. not an exact match, but it's a lot closer, so it'll do. Well, next step's going to take, and where do you think the pitfall will be in this project, and where it could be difficult? Honestly, like, a lot of difficult parts are kind of ahead of me on this project. I think groom will be uniquely challenging in that I need to make a groom that's flat to the head but still looks appealing. And I think, honestly, like, modeling the shirt will be difficult because I hate cloth modeling. Like, I despise it. Everything possibly to do with it, I hate Marvelous. I hate sculpting cloth in ZBrush. Like, I hate retopologizing cloth. Cloth is, like, one of the things that I despise most. Like, if there's anyone I could be more opposite from, it would be Laura from Outgang. Like, she's fucking fantastic with cloth, and I just... I'm not. Need to catch up with her, actually. It's been a while. We were going to go climbing more often, and then we just didn't. So I need to reach out, see if she wants to go climbing next week or something. Okay. Good work on the eyelids, man. You're pretty close already. Yeah, it's not too far off, but the eyes are definitely where it misaligns the most. By the way, I was doing some Maya ref lineups a while back. A classmate showed me what you can do with a flat plane geo that mimics AB swiping. First, second plane, entry relative, render stats, check, hold out, and you can move it across your match cam. I've not heard of that tip. But yeah. So it's like, allows you to kind of wipe, in a way, is that what you mean? If so, it's kind of cool. Okay. So we need to get this back into ZBrush. So let's File, Export, Selection. Maya Exports. Headscarf geo. Import. Modeling Maya. Exports headscarf geo. There we go. Yep. Yeah, that's a pretty cool tip. I've not actually done anything like that before, but I'll give it a try sometime. It won't be helpful right now, but maybe some point soon. Alright, cozy as always. Fuck yeah. I wondered why such a skilled groomer like yourself often has look dev jobs and not groom. I've been a look dev artist more than I've been a groom artist, actually. So, I mean, first off, thank you. But yeah, I ended up in groom by accident. Did it for just shy of 3 years, and I've been a look dev for 3.5. So I'm actually more of a look dev artist than I am of a groom artist. It is a why I do both. Honestly, I see myself more as a generalist. Like, my ideal job would be, I believe games industry call it a principal character artist, where basically what I want, like the dream for me, would be art director comes up to me, hey Mike, we got a month, here's a concept, we need something really cool for the client, and then I just get left alone. Like, honestly, for me, that'd be ideal. I love modeling stuff, I love experimenting with things. I want to learn texturing a bit more because I can texture, but I don't believe I can texture to a professional standard. At least not, you know, anything beyond a junior. So yeah, I can obviously groom and look dev fairly well. I just want to be able to do everything. So going from groom to look dev was just a case of, hey, like, you know, I don't just want to do groom all the time. Going back to a groom-only job now, and I'm looking forward to that because I've done look dev for so long. But yeah, at some point, ideally, I'll get a generalist role somewhere and see where that takes me. Right, okay, so we need to look into this knot, don't we? I'm gonna Where's my... Do I not have pure effort? Huh. Like an hour into the stream without opening my ref. Bad practice. Okay. So I'm gonna just search. Head, scarf, knot. I don't know why this throws me through such a loop. Like, I'm looking at it, and I don't understand it. Like, am I just really dumb? Fingers crossed that you find what you're looking for. Thanks for the answer, big up. How are you going to go about the knot? Painfully, or is there a good tip? Painfully. That's how I do everything. I think the way that I did the knot for Mona's shoelaces was quite nice. In that, I literally got a diagram of like a tied knot, copied a Nebs curve to follow it, and then just added depth and turned that into a lace, like just turned it into a cylinder. Okay, but like, why don't I understand this? Dragging them into here because it's quicker than loading them in Google. I always forget about that. ASAP Rocky used to wear that shirt. That's so funny. Oh, Jesus. Oh, that's okay, cool. A helpful image. I still don't understand it. Why am I struggling so much to understand the knot? Like, it should be so simple, and my brain is just not getting it. Let's see. What else is there? See, when you search headscarf, most of the results are kind of like Middle Eastern, like traditional headscarves. And African headscarves as well. Hello, matey. Hey, dude, how's it going? I just need to find a video of tying a headscarf. Oh, I've got it. And there's a channel. Oh my god. There's a there's a YouTube channel called How to Tie a Scarf. It's made for me in this moment. I love the hair. That's cool. So I just need to get some knot. Okay, so the twisting I'm not too bothered about. No. Oh, no, it is.
Ooh.
Okay. So... under, through, and then through. So this is that one. That's that one. Okay, that helps a fair bit. I'll dock that. Let's get into ZBrush. So what I'm going to do, what am I going to do? Is the reference not the same? It's not quite the same knot. But I think it's close enough. Your living organism and all its behavior. It's expressing it as a thing. So, let's... I'm gonna duplicate... No, I'm not. Append sphere. It's what I call a true learning experience. Yeah, shit's fucking with me. Fucking with me bad. Big cylinder with two bits going off each side. Yes, pretty much. Okay. So let's do a geometry. Modified topology, make sure it's centered. Okay, so then first thing, do that. B-I-T. Doing this a few times, it will eventually stretch out. There we go. Subtool, geometry, Z remesh. Okay, polygroup. Okay, so this bit. Don't even know what I'm doing anymore. I'm losing the plot. Wondering, would it be better? Not sure. So then, back to the how to tie a scarf video. Okay, so then we can do geometry, sorry, subtool, split. Hidden. Cool, and then duplicate that. Cool. Merge down. Merge down. I can essentially actually mirror that. Yeah, I've no idea what I'm doing. I think it might be easier to polymodel, extrude one face at a time. Yeah, I think you're right. Back to Maya. So, perspective. Already in perspective. Okay, so. Oh, I forgot it has a thickness. Let's quickly fix that. Where are you? Thing. Complete this, you don't know. Plane. What's going on? Oh, world symmetry's on. Okay. So once we got that in place, duplicate it. Okay. So then so in essence, that's how it's tied. Why is that so sensitive? How is this? How do you resolve that? Or does that just need to get squished down? Z4, what do you think? Oh yeah, it's going to get pulled in front of this one, isn't it? Yeah, there we go. So not sure how this gets resolved, but I imagine it just gets pulled, like squished up. But yeah, that's absolutely what it will be. I'd need to make that volume preserving somehow, but one thing I'm curious about. How many 17? Had to be an awkward one, didn't it? So if I roughness in half. Then smooth it. We get 4, 8, it'd be 16. So if I cut this into, actually, bevel, stuff like that. Smooth, smooth. 12. How the hell did I get 17? This test does have a Sisyphus feel to it, doesn't it? Will it stay separate mesh, or are you going to build it into the rest of the headscarf? Probably build it into the rest. I haven't quite figured that out yet. One problem at a time. Okay, so... If I go to insert edge loop, insert edge loop, multiple, 16, 17, there we go. So if I insert 8 loops, I want to smooth that. It's going to give me 18, isn't it? Okay. it's edge loop. 16. See, if I was any good at cloth sim, I'd now just sim this and tighten it up, but I'm not good at cloth sim, so I'm not going to. Let's see. So to ask again, I don't know if I missed or if you were too busy, but what was the average days of solar devices look like? What types of projects you work on would be doing? I mean, the projects are just going to depend on the vendor, right? Like if you're working for Digital Domain, it's not going to be the same as if you're working for Blue Zoo. But it's just the nature of being an artist in the industry. Depends on what your day looks like. I mean, I don't really know how to answer that beyond... Like, you just shade things all day. Like, you just make really nice looking look diff. And that's your entire point of being. There's not much else to it, honestly. Just make pretty pictures. Thank you. Sounds too good to be true. I was just working at a big studio, to be honest. Like, when you work at a big studio, you just do your task. Like, you don't often have to worry about what other people are doing. You just do it. Like, I wish I could give a more elaborate answer, but I don't think I can. Like, you know, I mean, I could explain it as if you didn't know what Looklev was, but I think that'd be insulting your intelligence. Very iterative processes, isn't that? For writing, say, a displacement map out and nuke, what compression? They should all be the same. Like, so long as you're writing 32-bit, the compression shouldn't affect the absolute values so much. So you should be okay. I mean, it's not something exactly I've tested, but in the past I've used all sorts of different compressions and never had an issue. The edge flow is still the best tool. I find the default is quite good. I would stay away from DWAB. Oh, never had it cause issues before. Granted, I just use zip. See, what I want to do is just add thickness, like uniformly add thickness. I know I can just like offset the mesh and then extrude, but that's no fun. Extruding every face by double that. There it is. And it works. Looks a bit shit though, doesn't it? I feel like it would have been better just modeling it. I can sculpt this. So I need to take 2 to 17. I see something very unsatisfying. That's pretty bad. Do we try sculpting this? See if we can get something out of it. Yeah, I kind of hate this. Didn't even match it up, did I? Okay. So that one doesn't work. This one might. What I'm trying to do is find if we've got those exact shapes anywhere. Kind of do the, got the cross, it's kind of inverted though. So the reference didn't bother, yeah. I'm gonna try taking this into ZBrush where it currently is. Modify, free transforms, file, export selection. Head, scarf, knot, geo. Subtool, append, sphere, okay. Import. We can make that work. So let's go into geometry. Don't ask me about combining them yet. I don't know. I don't know how I'm going to do that. The 17 edges is really, really annoying. So if we go to dynamic subdiv, get a lucky roll on zero mesh. This will keep hitting it until I get 17 edges. Why are you so concerned about edges? What's the thought process? If I want to connect this geometry and this geometry, I need there to be 17 edge loops. On one or the other. Doesn't need to be on both, naturally. Well, it does need to be on both, but I don't need to change both. Thank you. I miss so much what's happening. I don't know anymore either, to be fair. Push. Okay. This isn't going away. Okay, one moment. Which one is it? I think it's this one. Super dark now. I think I can make that work. So, 17 edges, eh? That means being forced to break symmetry now, because the topology will not be symmetrical when I do that. I mean, the model won't be symmetrical either, so. And cloth shouldn't be symmetrical, so I shouldn't be bitching about that, really. So let's get this back in to Maya, export. Modeling, ZBrush, sculpting, exports, head scarf knot. I can delete this one. In fact, actually, let's keep it. Let's do an AB. Import. The difference quick skill pass will make, eh? There's no changes between them, topology wise. Sculpting is a cheat code, change my mind. Thanks for letting me chat you off. I'm gonna head and relax before bed. No worries, man. Best of luck for the project. Are you streaming tomorrow? Work from home day, so a good swing by. Yeah, I should be streaming tomorrow. I'll be taking a longer lunch, I think, because unless Cassia can't make it anymore, I'm just going to a really nice little deli place. One of my favorite. I mean, I think I'll probably just go there anyway, regardless of whether or not she wants to go. I've got a tendency of just going, regardless. But yeah, I'll be there tomorrow. I'll be on here tomorrow, even. Okay. So we need to get this into 17. That's currently 4. Take care. No worries, man. You too. Best luck, you top of challenges. Fuck. Should be fine. Should be able to reproject a lot of it without too much issue. I'll get a lot of issue with overhangs, but that's not too big of a deal to fix. I mean, hell, the entire scarf was basically done today, so. Okay, we need to get started. Postponing it forever. Won't save anyone. I'm wondering, can I delete a single edge loop anywhere here? If I delete this, how bad is it? Scarf's almost there. It is, it's getting there. I need to find an edge somewhere to delete. Because then it's 16. Then it's really easy. If I deleted that one, it wouldn't be terrible. I could space those edges back out to fix that. That wouldn't be bad. Wouldn't be bad at all. Gonna rewind that. Alt save. then delete that again. Relax brush to save the day. Let's turn symmetry on before we do that. Symmetry world. I suspect with relaxed brushes, it tries its best to maintain the current shape. I think that can work. Okay, so that gives us 16. That doesn't. 16, there we go. So I can smooth that twice. They are now a match. Okay, now what? Now I need to cut that off and cut it off there. Okay, combine. It's gonna be an absolute mess. Are you ready? So, let's solo this. What we want to do is bridge those two. Oh god. Okay, bridge. Topologically sound. It's so dense though. I really don't like that. It feels so unnecessary. And why does it feel denser? Like, it's the same amount of polygons. Like, I know it's strictly speaking because it's less area. Let's export this. File, export selection. Headscarf, geo. Okay, append this. Import. Capture the front of the chassis. Yeah, the thought crossed my mind a moment ago. It's so dense. It really doesn't need to be that dense. But it technically does. Tweak the shape a little. Yeah, I'm gonna keep tweaking it, don't worry. Come on, there we go. Yeah, I could reduce the top of just the knot. I do want to keep it as part of the same object, though. Really need to change the edge of this though before I get too far. too many. Ooh, actually, that would help a lot. Okay, yeah, let's delete this. Looks more bearable. Doesn't look as bad. I need to delete every nth edge. Anyone know how to do that? Maya, delete every nth edge. Bonus tools, isn't it? The entire thing. Gotta assume it's Mel. Oh my god, it works really quick. Okay, cool. Okay, so it's not perfect, but it's considerably more appealing to look at. You can select one edge out of every edge loop, and then trim details. I think the select every nth is the way to go for that one. So I need this to end. general statement, really. let's see. is it? 5:30. Okay, I'm not gonna finish this today. That's okay. It's moving very fast. It's moving fairly quick. I'm entering that stage of like sheer disappointment. Where I know I could have done this better. But it's a pretty natural stage of every project. Okay, that's looking better. Fold. Can you tell that our mesh is a little bit uneven? Okay. In. Why? Like, why? Jesus. Damn sight better. Line. Max V. Finish before 200. Nah. You'll be amazed how much it slows down. That's the thing you compete with in CG. Somewhere along the line, I've just made a condom. Okay, so let's go align UVs, min V. Where does it slow down? Already has. There we go. Get. Any progress on everything? Yeah, already has slowed down.
beautiful.
Cannot put into words how much I despise this. Okay. Interesting. File, export selection. Geometry. Actually, let's go up to 5. Import. If characters take this long, I wonder if towns and cities are worse. Kind of. Not really. The thing is with characters is they're very complex. Buildings, although not easy, have less inherent complexity to them in terms of what the viewer will notice. So with a building, there's a lot of props involved. Like, you know, you need to make an air conditioning unit, you need to make windows, you need to make all that stuff. But the thing is, you can just throw on some tileable textures, and it will work well enough for most things. And so the modeling can be fairly basic, just a lot of parts. And the texturing and look dev can be extremely basic. Human characters is a lot more going on. Like, a lot more going on. So you can't really get away with that stuff as much. Okay, so I'm going to very quickly just sculpt something onto this guy, and then I'm going to head off, because I'm beat. brush, auto masking, topological. Appreciate the time you're able to share with us. Thanks, man. I appreciate that. Export. It's GovGeo. Actually, let's ZBrush. Okay, there we go. So I'm gonna let this clean up, and then I'm gonna go lift some weights and put them back down. So yeah, that'll be it for today. It feels like it's not been productive, but we did a lot, so I just need to go easier on myself. That was like a bit of shit though. We'll need to fix the shape of those. But either way, we've made a good bit of progress, so I feel like, yeah, it's, a lot's been achieved. So now it's just a case of continuing, make it look like it doesn't suck, and yeah, at some point fairly soon, I'll want to do some kind of proxy textures, because looking at grey all the time is going to drive me a little bit insane. But we'll get there when we get there. But yeah, I'll be back on tomorrow, same time as today. and we'll take it from there and see what we want to do. Cool. As always, if you want to ask any questions or anything, there's a Discord in the description. Feel free to drop by there. I tend to be on there most of the night. And yeah, I'll hopefully see you tomorrow. Cool. Bye, guys.